Hey guys, it's Stephanie with Simmerkey, and welcome to a quick tutorial on how to make your very own custom stilt foundations in The Sims 4 using columns. Now, this is a pretty simple concept. However, I realize that not a lot of people know about this. So what we're gonna do is, first of all, we're gonna build a room, and then we're gonna go directly on top of it and build another room. And then we're gonna delete the room underneath it. Now I believe I have bb.move objects on. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab some columns, and we're gonna grab the Get Famous in blue. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place these directly under the room, exactly where I would want my stilts to go. And let's get some in the back as well. This is just a small room to show you exactly how this works. So now, obviously, a lot of people know you can do this, right? You can put the columns underneath it, but here's the trick. If you put the columns underneath first, then you can grab the room. Oops, don't turn it. Grab the room and find this arrow here that you see in the middle, which is our foundation height. And you're gonna actually lower that. And what that does is it pushes the columns underground. So now we have our very own stilted foundation. Now, the cool thing about using this instead of the ones that came with the game are you can actually still landscape underneath them. And of course, you can pick all sorts of different styles and colors. So all I have to do is take whatever landscaping I want, and it's gonna go directly underneath there. If you use the new stilted foundations we got with base game, unfortunately, you cannot landscape under the house. Now, this does technically work with a water lot. However, I was getting a bit of a weird visual glitch, so let me show you exactly what that looks like, and you could judge for yourself if you wanna use that one or not. Okay, so here we are on a water lot in Sulani, and we're gonna do the exact same concept. We're gonna draw one room slightly over the water as well. I find it easier to just copy the room and put it on top of itself. Otherwise, you can just draw one on top. And once again, we're gonna delete the room on the bottom. Now, actually, the best way that I found to do this is to, instead of either making an entire room or deleting an entire room, just use a flat square. You can either do it how I did it here and delete the walls, or you could simply use the flat square from the custom room tools over here. So the reason I'm doing this is otherwise the columns will not line up with the bottom of the top room, and then it'll look funny. So we're gonna grab these same columns that we used here. Of course, you could use any ones that you like, but I like those because they come in blue. And once again, we're gonna grab our room on top, find the little arrows in the middle, and then, oh, do we have BB? Oh, sorry, then you have to delete the bottom floor. I will get this right. So there we go. By doing that, they actually stick to the top of the floor instead of having a big gap there. So once we delete that base, because we don't need it any longer, now we're going to grab our arrow and we're going to bring this all the way down into the water. So I can't quite tell if this is a visual glitch or what, but you see how you kind of see a surface there. It's kind of hard to see, but you also see like this sandy part, what looks like down there. So it's not the best way to do it over a water lot, unless that really doesn't bother you. And I think the reason it does this is because these lots are sort of sloped. So I think that's just like tricking the game mechanics. So it wasn't really prepared for that. But yeah, I'm sure you creative people will find amazing ways to use this trick. So have fun. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss my next tutorial. I have a ton more coming, and I have two playlists linked in the description, one for beginners to teach you pretty much how to start building in The Sims, all your basic tips and tricks, how to learn the user interface, what each button does, etc., all the way up to our advanced tutorial series where I teach you things like this, open doors, open counters, custom whatever. So make sure to check those out, and I will see you guys next time. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye! Wait guys, before you go anywhere, don't forget to click over here to watch new videos, and click on my face when I disappear to subscribe.